Some of my patients take Coenzyme Q10 and they ask my opinion if this is a good supplement to help with their chronic pain. Today, I will review the scientific evidence of CoQ10 for pain and I'll give my honest opinion if this works or not. So, let's talk about CoQ10 today. Coenzyme Q10, or ubiquinone, is a vitamin-like substance involved in the energy sources for all the cells in the human body. Our body produces our own CoQ10, and it's present in small but adequate amounts on every diet. The natural sources of CoQ10 are cold water fish, meats, vegetable oils, whole grains, and some fruits like avocado. There are claims that people need a higher amount of CoQ10 to fix some health problems, and they will need to take supplements which contain a much higher amount than what is found in a regular healthy diet. Let's check if that's supported by scientific evidence or not. I will only review the topics related to chronic pain. And please don't forget that this video is for educational purposes only. If you have a condition that needs medical advice, please talk to your doctor. And if there is an emergency, go to the nearest emergency department. I will start by reviewing the scientific evidence studies of CoQ10 for migraine prevention. There are two studies showing that about half of the patients benefited from a decrease in their migraines of around 50% after they use daily CoQ10 for 3 months. CoQ10 supplements reduce both the severity and frequency of the migraine attacks. A further study showed that it seemed to work well in children and adolescents too. A recent clinical practice guideline prepared in Canada by the Alberta doctors recommend CoQ10 for the prevention of migraine in adults. But they acknowledge that this evidence, this recommendation, comes from low quality evidence and mostly on expert opinion of the people who developed this guideline. This Canadian headache guideline recommendations, they recommend using 100 milligrams 3 times a day for a total of 300 milligrams daily. If the person wants to find if this CoQ10 works for their migraine, they need to take daily for 3 months and chart their progress on a migraine diary. If they don't see any benefit in the number of migraine attacks after 3 months, then they should stop taking this supplement. That's why it is important to keep a diary and compare the number of days that they had a migraine attack before and after the 3 month trial. The second indication of CoQ10 for pain is muscle pain caused by cholesterol-lowering drugs. These are medications called statins, and examples are atorvastatin and simvastatin. The medical term for this painful condition is statin-induced myopathy. This myopathy is caused by mitochondrial dysfunction due to lack of CoQ10. People who are treated with statins, they have a 16 to 49% reduction in their blood levels of CoQ10. And we know that supplementation with CoQ10 maintains a normal blood level. So you may be asking, why don't we just measure the amount of CoQ10 in the blood? There is no use for doing that. There is no use for testing the amount of CoQ10 in the blood. We don't do that because the levels of CoQ10, this substance in the blood, are not indicative of how much CoQ10 there is inside of the cells. A recent meta-analysis published in 2021 included 8 studies in which 472 patients with statin-induced myopathy were treated with oral CoQ10 or placebo. The authors found no difference between those treated with CoQ10 and those treated with placebo. So despite these negative conclusions, there are still some clinicians who recommend patients to take CoQ10 supplements to avoid muscle pain caused by cholesterol-lowering drugs. I personally do not recommend it, but if my patients want to try, I tell them to try for 3 months to find if the pain is reduced with the supplement. Then, if they find it is, it's okay to continue taking. I tell them that it's important to continue taking the statins medication, which is so important to maintain their cholesterol levels in the normal range and avoid any cardiovascular complications. Is there a risk to take too much coenzyme Q10? While we still do not know the ideal daily dose, the studies have used doses of CoQ10 ranging from 50 milligrams to 1200 milligrams in adults, split into 3 doses per day. A typical daily dose is 100 milligrams to 200 milligrams per day. Coenzyme Q10 seems remarkably free from side effects, even when high doses are used. There are minimal gastrointestinal upset, like stomach pain, diarrhea, nausea, burning sensation in the mouth, or loss of appetite. People with chronic diseases such as heart failure, kidney, liver problems, or diabetes should be cautious if using this supplement. CoQ10 may lower the blood sugar levels and the blood pressure, so it's not recommended to take if the person has a history of low blood pressure. People taking thyroid medications, blood thinners, and chemotherapy should check with their doctors before using CoQ10 supplements. Given the lack of safety of CoQ10 supplements, they are not recommended for children or for women who are pregnant or breastfeeding. What is a good brand of coenzyme Q10? When you buy supplements, any type of supplements, remember that they are not regulated the same way that medicines are. So they may say that they contain certain quantities of substance, but that's not accurate. Manufacturers of natural health products can sell a product and claim health benefits without having to obtain the scientific evidence, the same supporting evidence that would be necessary if they were marketing a drug. It is always a good idea to talk to your pharmacist to check if the source of CoQ10 is from a reputable manufacturer. Below this video, in the description, there is a link to a document that you can download and read, and it summarizes all the content of this video. If you like this video, give a thumbs up here, turn on the notifications, and don't forget to subscribe to this channel. There is a share button here too, and you can send this video to your friends. I have many other videos on this channel. Check here for other topics. And you can also find me on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.